there, Pop.
I've got to hand it to your son for some smart figuring. Come on, let's get it out of here.
Hey, wait a minute. That doesn't feel right.
Rocks.
Stand here. Let's start digging them out.
It's tough, Bolton. We couldn't reach them now.
Coming, Bolton?
No. First, I'm going to find the gang that did this and wipe them out. They must be around here someplace. Well, are any of you going with me?
Yeah, we're with you, Bolton.
All right, you two take that side. Come on with me.
Lucky thing that old cribbing wasn't strong enough to hold that dirt.
You still got the spare play, Clay? Huh?
It might be a drift of the old pocket mine.
Yeah. Well, anyway, it's got to come out somewhere.
Guys around. I'll go ahead and take a look. See if the paratron's in any of those boxes.
About him. He's all tied up and tucked away.
Good. You ready?
Yeah, we'll have to shoot our way out of
here. And with one gun. I wish I'd...
I'm worried about.
we've got plenty of ammunition anyway, Bob. Here, you better stock up.
Here they come again. Look at those crazy fools, lighting torches so we can see them better.
Crazy, are they?
I mean crazy like fire.
In a dark alley. Wonder what they're up to now. I'll see.
Well, you saw.
Figure we'd never look for him up here. Go back and get the others.
We gotta get those flares out of here. You take the one over there and I'll get this one over here.
I know all about your blundering. We can't stay here. Hudson will come back and forth and wipe us out.
Hudson won't be there because you're going to get him fresh.
I don't follow you.
Listen, you'll be standing by gunside mine with your men. At the proper time, House will turn the paratron on the mine. In the confusion, your men will go in and finish the job.
I reached the end of my rope. I can't work under these conditions. Violence, fighting, murder.
Where are you going, Doctor?
To see Hudson. I'm going to make arrangements to take the paratron back to Seattle at once.
Please, Doctor, don't act in haste.
I've made up my mind.
A message come in from Brock. Turn the paratron on the mine buildings. Destroy everything you can, and be sure you get the Hudson's.
What about me?
Brandon is standing by. The explosion and fire will be his signal to attack.
I could do it right now. They're all in the house.
Now would be a bad time to move the paratron.
Why?
I can't promise anything. I just have a feeling things are coming to a climax.
And when they do, what will happen to the paratron, to all my work?
We'll have to take that chance. Just hope to strike before they do.
And I still say we ought to go back to Pocket with the Marshal and his men and wipe them out.
And I still say they're not going to sit there waiting for us.
So you think your plan will work?
I'm sure of it. It's only a matter of days. Maybe hours.
Thank you. Relax, boys. Nothing yet.
Busy, Doctor?
Yes, I'm very busy.
We don't.
Dr. Miller and I are about to conduct an experiment. So if you'll excuse me.
Oh, sure, go right ahead. Don't mind if I watch, do you?
Dr. Miller is in a rather nervous state.
Uh-huh. Too much excitement, huh?
If you please.
Sorry, I scared you, didn't I?
Thought it was water.
Of course not, you fool. Leave those chemicals alone, or you blow us all up.
Yeah, well, I guess I'll be going.
Thank you very much.
Oh, you're welcome. Hello.
Ooh, why is it loaded? What are we doing?
We were about to measure the speed of the life beam.
Oh, yes.
I have been making preparations.
I see.
What did Mr. Hudson say to your leaving?
Well, we'll wait a few days and see what develops.
There are some angles we're sure of. That radio message that fooled us into going to the abandoned mine was obviously a threat. And secondly, that outlaw who told us of the radio was prompted to do so while he was right here. Because naturally, he didn't figure on being captured at the hideout.
So it was an inside job. He got it from one of our men.
None of the miners was in the house, Pop. Nobody had a chance to talk to him.
Say, Jim. The boys are taking the cream of that hot quartz out right now. I thought you'd like to see it.
You bet.
That quartz is another reason why the doctor ought to stick around.
Coming, Ruth?
Yes, I will. I don't think I should go down, Jim. Dad worries me.
Well, your father's all right. We'll only be gone about 20 minutes. Come on.
Well, all right.
There you go.
We'll direct the beam through the window against the hill and measure the speed that way.
No, that way you won't get the distance, Doctor. Besides, it is too dangerous. I suggest we take the paratron outside and direct the beam into the sky, where it can do no harm.
You're quite right. It was very thoughtful something. I'll get a couple of boys to help us.
Seems to be getting stronger the deeper we go.
What are we stopping here for?
I want to show you the difference in the quartz on this top level.
You're not getting the stuff out fast enough. Put the men on a double shift.
Do we get a bonus?
You're getting too much overtime already.
Don't mind him. You'll get your bonus.
My belief the array will reach 20,000 feet. Now we'll see.
There's the beam. Stand by, men, any minute now.
Give it more juice.
We're depending on you to get the ore out.
I'll get it out. Okay, Bob.